Hi guys.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you tonight?
I'm fine.
Fine, Jamilet. How are you? Muted, Eddie, Jorge. Welcome to another class. Okay, we're going to start. All right. Let me see, where did we leave off? One second. ¿En qué sección nos quedamos? Ando medio perdida ahorita. Section 4. 3. Jorge, can you hear me? Eddie, are you there?
Hi.
Hi, Eddie. How are you tonight?
Fine.
Okay, I'm glad to hear that. ¿Ya empezaron a trabajar en el midterm?
No.
The
no.
Weekend.
On the weekend. Okay.
Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
Bueno, antes del midterm creo que estábamos. Section 3. Job profiles. This is the one. Sorry. If your job is dangerous. Oh, this is the one. All right, let's watch this video. Everybody mute the microphone, please. And let's pay attention. Here we go. Siempre en la clase de ustedes me pone un poco lenta porque está guardando la clase anterior.
Hi everyone. In this class you'll learn placement of adjectives. Particularly, you will learn be plus adjective and noun plus adjective. Let's get started by listening to a conversation title. That's exciting. Let's listen and practice.
Hey, Stephanie, I hear you have a new job.
Yes, I'm teaching math at Lincoln High School.
How do you like it?
It's great. The students are terrific. How are things with you?
Not bad. I'm a firefighter now, you know.
That's exciting.
Yes, but it's a very stressful job, and sometimes it's dangerous.
In essence, what we want to learn is how to express the same thing, but in different ways. First, let's analyze the examples on the left-hand side of this chart, be plus adjective. We can follow this formula to better understand this topic. Article, a or an, plus profession, plus apostrophe, plus job, plus verb to be, plus adjective. Now let's analyze the first example on the chart. A firefighter's job is dangerous. At the beginning of our sentence, we will typically use an article whenever we're talking about a singular job. So in this case, a. Then we have profession plus apostrophe s, which expresses possessive, plus job. After that, we're going to add the verb to be, in this case is. Finally, we put the adjective. Let's look at our next example. A doctor's job is stressful. At the beginning of our sentence, we have an article, in this case a. Then we have profession plus apostrophe s, which expresses possessive, plus job. After that, we have the verb to be, is. Finally, we have the adjective, stressful. Now, we want to express these same examples using adjective plus noun. We can follow this formula to better understand this topic. Article, a or an, plus profession, plus has, plus article, A or an plus adjective plus noun. So let's make sense of the first example now. A firefighter has a dangerous job. At the beginning of our sentence, we will use an article. A. Then we will have the profession. Firefighter. After that, we add the verb has. Next, the article A. Then we will add the adjective. And finally, we need to add the noun, which in this case is job. Now, I would like to give you some adjectives which may describe different jobs. And then I would like for you to express your opinion about different jobs that we have learned so far. Let me read them for you. Boring, easy, dangerous, exciting, difficult, stressful. So, using the adjectives that I just gave you, I would like for you to describe different jobs. And I would like for you to express your ideas in different ways, using B plus adjectives and adjective plus noun. For example, a lawyer's job is stressful. A lawyer has a stressful job. After you finish this activity.
Okay, repeat with me. We're going to look at the structure and how to say it the same way. So, a firefighter's job is dangerous.
A firefighter's job is dangerous.
A
doctor's job is stressful.
A doctor's job is stressful.
Right, we're going to read both, okay? So, a firefighter's job is dangerous.
A firefighter's job is dangerous.
A firefighter has a dangerous job.
A firefighter has a dangerous job.
A doctor's job is stressful.
A doctor has a stressful job.
No, a doctor's job is stressful.
A doctor's job is stressful.
And a doctor has a stressful job.
A doctor has a stressful job.
Very good. Okay, so I want you to write both the equivalents, all right, using these adjectives. Take a screenshot, please, of the adjectives.
Boring.
Boring, easy, dangerous. Well, let's read them. These are adjectives, okay? Boring.
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 Easy.
Dangerous.
Dangerous.
Exciting.
Exciting. Exciting.
Difficult.
Difficult.
Stressful.
Stressful.
Stressful. Very good. Okay. So how are you going to make sentences using that? All right. Let's take a look.
Please share your work in our discussion forums.
One second. I cannot move this. Guys, mute the microphone, please. All right. So look.
Attend this topic.
Here's how we're going to do it. All right. Anyway. Using the adjectives, imagine we're going to use boring. Can you think of a profession or occupation that is boring? So imagine this is the adjective,
that is
right?
Boring?
A profession or occupation that is boring. Can you think of one? We're going to follow this structure. What do you think?
A salesperson.
A salesperson. Yo creo que de las más aburridas del mundo es ser guardia de seguridad.
Ah,
right?
Yes.
Because you have to work 24 hours sometimes. A lot. Okay, for example, A. Hagámoslo de las dos formas, okay? Ayúdenme.
Security guard.
Security guard. Apostrophe job. S, job, okay. A security job. Guard's job. Uh-huh.
It's boring.
It's boring. Okay, and what is the equivalent?
Security guard has a boring job.
A security guard has a boring job. So we're using both structures, right? Okay, another example, Jorge. You're going to help me, all right? Now we're going to use the word, let me see, what other words do we have? Difficult. All right, Jorge, help me with one, or everybody, what's a difficult job, guys?
Accounting.
Accounting is difficult?
Yes, because so with money.
Yeah, it's like delicate, right? Let's do that. Okay, Jorge, help me, Jorge. We're going to talk about an accountant, okay? Go ahead. No, I don't hear you, Jorge. Maybe Nathalie. Nathalie, help me.
Trabajo social.
Uh-huh, okay. No, no, but we're going to do the example with an accountant. Help me make the structure.
Ay, no entiendo.
Vamos a hacer lo mismo. En vez del security guard, estamos usando difficult. El adjetivo difficult, okay? Y hacer las dos oraciones. Aquí usamos security guard para las dos, con las dos formas de acá. Y ahora vamos a hablar de un accountant. Entonces, ¿cómo lo formaría, Nathalie? Siga los modelos.
Ajá. A accountant. As a job is boring.
An accountant's job.
De
las dos formas. No, hoy estamos usando difficult.
Ah, difficult. ¿Y cuál era ese?
An accountant's difficult. Job is difficult.
Uh-huh.
¿La otra difficult. Forma?
Uh-huh. As a accountant.
Accountant, yes.
Accountant, uh-huh. Y as.
Yes.
As difficult.
As a difficult. Mm-hmm. Job. A difficult job. Very good. Okay, one more example and then you are going to do the exercises, okay? So next one, let me see who. Yesenia. Yesenia, you're going to do one that says exciting, all right? That's your adjective, exciting. Eso es emocionante, okay? So what profession is exciting, guys? Let's think.
Lawyer.
Lawyer?
Exciting.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. So let's make the sentence.
A lawyer's profession?
No, a lawyer's job.
A lawyer's job. A lawyer's job is exciting.
Very good. And the other form is?
A lawyer. Has an exciting job.
An exciting job. Sí, fíjense en esto. Yo sé que no lo hemos visto, pero acá cuando escribo AN es porque viene una vocal. Acá hay una vocal. Ok. Y acá también. Por eso es como un contador y un security guard. Este tiene N porque empieza con vocal. Okay, fíjense en eso. So a lawyer has an exciting job. Very good. Okay. ¿Creen que lo pueden hacer en parejas? Pero vamos a cambiar estos ejemplos. Y hay que hacer un ejemplo de 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hagan. 5 profesiones. ¿Ok? Si pueden, manden el screenshot de la estructura para trabajar con eso y los adjetivos. ¿Ok? ¿Ready?
Yes.
Let's work in pairs. Here we go. Accept the invitation, please.
Hola.
Hola.
¿Entendió más o menos lo que vamos a hacer?
Sí. Vamos a hacer una profesión como lo que hacía.
Va.
Abierta la plataforma, yo. ¿Hola?
¿Cuál sería? ¿Qué? ¿No sabe qué literal es?
No, es que no tengo abierta la plataforma ahorita. Entonces envían la foto al WhatsApp.
Porque sí, ahí están los ejemplos que yo hice. Y bueno, nadie mandó lo del video, lo voy a mandar yo. Y ahí ven.
Ok.
Pero siempre abran la plataforma antes de ingresar para tener esto a la mano.
Teacher, tenemos que hacer 5 de los que están aquí. De Boring, AC, Dangerous o de otros.
No, esos mismos con otras profesiones usando la estructura que les da allí y pueden usar de ejemplo los que yo hice. Están las dos imágenes en WhatsApp.
Gracias.
No veamos.
Se las voy a reenviar al grupo.
Vaya, gracias.
Para que ahí las tengamos. Vaya, ya las envié. Va, entonces armemos la. Ay.
Casi no se ve.
¿Yo?
Iron.
Jairo, hi. Pensando en usted estaba porque nunca falta, ni Vladimir.
No, vengo llegando.
Pobrecito, sudando. Ok, sí. Vladimir, cuéntele a Jairo qué estamos haciendo.
Si te puedes meter al WhatsApp ahorita, la teacher me mandó unas imágenes.
Ah, sí, eso estaba viendo.
Ajá, entonces, de la segunda imagen, vamos a escoger 5 de ellos para hacer oraciones como la imagen 1, pero con diferentes profesiones.
Ok.
Uh-huh. Itzy sería entonces Angisi, porque es vocal, ¿verdad?
Ah, y dijo que cuando comenzaba una vocal se ponía N, ¿va?
Yeah, sí, perfecto.
Yes, ajá.
Angisi.
Ahí sí,
ajá.
Easy teacher.
Ahí sí.
Ajá.
No, porque eso sería un profesor fácil. Sería como
fácil de comprar.
La risa, Jorge.
Entonces sería,
justo la estructura de
la teacher, a teacher,
entonces sería a teacher,
estresante,
sí, estresante,
podría ser a pilot job is stressful.
Ajá, perfect. No. Yeah.
¿Puede ser así, va?
Yeah.
Ok.
Con el apóstrofe S, ¿verdad? Pilot's job is stressful. And then the equivalent.
También podría ser...
A pilot,
pero
a stressful job.
Exactly. Perfect. Good job, guys.
Okay.
Oh, easy, vaya, voy yo.
Right. Easy.
Uh-huh. A nurse job is easy. La otra forma sería a nurse has an easy job.
Okay, es tu turno, Edwin.
A nurse dijo.
Uh-huh.
Okay, sería a doctor job is difficult.
Okay.
Y él lo transforma.
La otra forma sería a doctor.
A banca del banco.
Veamos, ¿dónde está? A banker. Bien. Así se dice, a banker.
Ajá.
Un banquero. Un
banker. Ajá, podría ser, ¿verdad? Es peligroso porque si le llegan a saltar.
I am banker.
Ajá, a banker.
Vale, entonces sería. Vamos a ver. I'm banker.
Ajá.
Banker job is dangerous.
Is.
¿Cómo dijiste que se pronunciaba?
Dangerous.
Dangerous.
King's job.
Esa es como cuál forma.
Esa es la primera, la T más adjetivo. Es
okay.
A king's job is boring. Y la otra forma, que es el adjetivo más nombre, es a king has a boring job.
Turno, uh-huh.
Ya utilizando el has, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. Ya te tiene un trabajo, sí.
Ajá.
Ya te explico. Por ejemplo.
Ocupar cualquier profesión.
Por ejemplo, sería a designer job.
¿Ya lo ocupamos? De los que tenemos acá.
Veamos.
Difficult. ¿Qué es dificultoso?
Será dificultoso ser difícil. Cantante. ¿Cuál otro
por las tonalidades, digo? No sé.
Sí, va. Sí.
Sacar el tono. El...
Porque aún, algunos ni hablar, podemos menos cantar.
Cabal. Va, entonces eso sería.
Sería difficult.
Difficult. Difficult.
¿Cómo se pronuncia?
No sé. Difficult. Difficult. Por ahí está la teacher.
Teacher.
Difficult.
Yes, difficult. Tell me. You finished.
¿Cómo se pronuncia difficult?
Difficult.
Ah, sí, difficult.
Uh-huh. Difficult. Entonces sería así.
Okay. Good job. Todos estaban haciéndolo perfecto. Algunos los felicité, otros no, porque me cambiaba cuando iba a hacerlo. Yes, it was a great job. All right. Give me some examples. Cada uno deme un ejemplo, okay? Quickly. Go ahead.
Okay. A designer job is funny. A designer has a funny job.
Mm-hmm, very good. Y yo hablando y solo usted está aquí, creo. Ya miras.
No solo usted.
Espérame, ya vienen los demás. Okay. Y yo, bueno. Give me another example. Go ahead.
A engineer job is stressful. A engineer has a stressful job.
No, that's engineers.
Engineers.
Okay. Good job, everyone. Ya están mejorando bastante. Y creo que ustedes mismos lo notan también. Espero, espero. Ok, todos denme un ejemplo de los que hicieron. Uno por uno, quickly, please. One example.
Yo.
Ay, ok, Vladimir.
Sería a pilot. Job is stressful.
Perfect, Jairo.
A engineer. Job difficult.
Very good. Is no, difficult. Yes, very good. Okay, Natalie.
A teacher has his job.
Has an easy
his teacher.
A teacher has an easy.
Has his
easy.
Go. Easy.
Job. Very good, Yesenia.
Job.
A banker job is difficult.
Very good. Jorge.
A banker job is dangerous.
Really? Jorge, you are a banker, right?
Yes, I am banker.
No les puedo contar cuántos con cuántos bancarios trabajo al día. Casualidad.
Es la única palabra que me puedo, amor.
No, pero en este grupo como cuatro creo que son bancarios o cinco.
Sobre luego, todo en la noche, teacher.
Son todos.
No, no, pero y después todas las otras clases que doy las doy en un banco. Así que todos son bancarios. Ahí, mensaje de la vida. I don't know what it is. Okay. Yesenia, hold on. ¿Quién me faltaba? Eddie, one example. Eddie's not there. Yesenia, did you tell me yours? Your example?
Okay. A lawyer job is
okay, very good. Eddie?
Hola.
Your example, Eddie?
Copia entonces para ver
la
hace la copia,
¿no? Y
de un testimonio. Igual.
Okay. I can't hear you well. All right, we're going to watch this video. Everybody, mute the microphone.
Hi, everyone. In this class, you'll develop prediction and inferencing skills after reading and discussing an article on job profiles.
Reading. Job profiles.
Lisa Parker has two jobs. She works as a waitress at night, but she's really an actress. During the day, she auditions for plays and television shows. Her schedule is difficult, and she's tired a lot, but she's following her dream.
Lots of teenagers want John Blue's job. He plays video games for 8 hours a day, and he gets paid for it. John is a video game tester for a big video game company. Is it ever boring? Never. John almost always wins.
Becky Peck walks in the park every day for many hours, rain or shine. Becky is a professional dog walker. She walks dogs for other people. Sometimes she takes 20 dogs to the park at one time.
Carlos Ruiz is a busy man. He plans lessons, grades homework, helps with after-school activities, and, of course, he teaches. His salary isn't great, but that's okay. His students like his class, so he's happy.
She walks dogs for other people. Sometimes she takes 20 dogs to the park at one time.
Okay, did you hear the pronunciation of the words? Yes? All right, here. Pay attention one more time, all right? We'll play. Pongan atención a la pronunciación porque luego les toca a ustedes, ¿verdad? Y anoten algunas que sean difíciles. Take notes of difficult ones. Here we go.
Hey everyone. In this class, you'll develop prediction and inferencing skills after reading and discussing an article on job profiles.
Reading. Job profiles.
Lisa Parker has two jobs. She works as a waitress at night, but she's really an actress. During the day, she auditions for plays and television shows. Her schedule is difficult, and she's tired a lot, but she's following her dream.
Lots of teenagers want John Blue's job. He plays video games for 8 hours a day, and he gets paid for it. John is a video game tester for a big video game company. Is it ever boring? Never. John almost always wins.
Becky Peck walks in the park every day for many hours, rain or shine. Becky is a professional dog walker. She walks dogs for other people. Sometimes she takes 20 dogs to the park at one time.
Carlos Ruiz is a busy man. He plans lessons, grades homework, helps with after-school activities, and, of course, he teaches. His salary isn't great, but that's okay. His students like his class, so he's happy. Always wins.
Okay, questions about the vocabulary? No? What is grade homework?
Teacher, during
auditions, eh?
Uh-huh.
Audiciona. She auditions for plays. What is plays?
During.
Auditions for plays. What is that? No idea. Audiciona para obras.
Okay.
Teatrales, okay.
Obras.
This is schedule. Repeat, schedule.
Schedule
is como el horario, okay? Her schedule.
Questions
here?
What's the meaning teenager?
Teenager. Let me see.
Teenager
is adolescentes.
Yeah.
Teenagers, adolescentes.
Yes.
Lesson.
Here?
Ajá, lesson.
Las lecciones.
Lesson.
Grades. Homework. What is that?
When.
A boy.
Califica tareas, dice acá. Grades. Homework.
Homework.
It is homework. It is
homework.
Homework,
for
sure.
Always one.
Right. And what else? That's it?
Yes.
Yes, aha, exactly. All right, now, hold on. We're going to work on the activity, all right? Answer the questions, but before you answer, take turns in reading one, okay? So read first, read with the pronunciation, okay? And then do the exercise. Ready?
Okay. Ready.
Okay, let's practice. Here we go. Hold on. I'm going to change some of you. All right. Accept the invitation, please.
Okay, voy a compartirla.
Okay.
¿Para qué?
Lisa Parker has two jobs. She works as waitress at night, but she's really an actress. During the day, she auditions for plays and television shows. Her schedule is difficult and she's tired a lot, but she's following her dream.
Okay. Sería video games tester.
Yes.
Los Ostenenger was John Blue. John has played.
Sorry, are you working together?
Teacher, ¿es practicar la pronunciación o completar el ejercicio?
Siempre, sí, siempre que haya una lectura hay que leerla, un párrafo cada uno y luego hacer el ejercicio.
Ah, ok.
Ah, vale. Ok.
Entonces, hoy sí. Vale, voy a leer entonces la que acaba de leer usted.
Ok.
Lots of the...
Si no, hagámosla.
La voy a enviar para los que no pueden entrar.
A ver, porque está dando problemas la plataforma, me daba error.
Sí, así, así da cuando uno quiere ingresar.
Le puede ver la imagen, cualquier cosa, pero como hay que responder las preguntas.
Ajá. En la plataforma.
Sí. Uh-huh. Bueno, inténtelo. A mí también me dio problemas. Pero, a ver.
Es la 3.12, ¿verdad, teacher?
Yes. Ay, no se ve. No, access the platform, that's better.
¿Le cayeron las imágenes en WhatsApp a ti?
Sí, sí, sí.
¿Cuál es the part? Every day for money horse. Right or Sydney Becky is a professional. The worker, she work the for other people. So maintenance, she talk to 20, ¿cómo se pronuncia, teacher?
¿Cuál? ¿Cuál palabra?
20.
Número 20. 20.
Sí, Jairo. Noto que está mejorando bastante y está súper bien. También quisiera que después de clase o antes, por ejemplo, este video lo vea y repita, porque ajá, como está usando y repitiendo un poquito, porque yo hacía eso, yo también le puede ayudar con pronunciación.
Okay.
No le estoy diciendo que está mal, pero sí, a mí me sirvió también.
Sí, a mí me cuesta bastante.
No, pero no pasa nada, es normal. Ponga este video okay. Otra vez después de clase, si puede un rato, y quédese repitiendo un poco, o mañana.
Ok.
Ok, continue. Whose turn is it?
Those to the part I'm not team.
Ok. Esa la leo ahora yo, Jairo. Sí.
The next one. Yeah, two professions, Jairo, and two okay. Professions, Eddie. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Ok, yo teacher, entonces. Okay. Mm-hmm. Carlos Ruiz is a busy man. He plans lesson grades homework, helps with after school activities, and of course, he teaches. His salary isn't great,
right?
But that's
Becky. My boy, yo con Becky. Becky walks in the park every day for many hours. No sé si dice race
hours.
Or
for many hours.
Many hours.
Yes.
Many?
Hours.
Hours. Many hours. Rain or shine.
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 Uh-huh. Shine.
Shine. Okay. ¿Y eso qué es? ¿Chai qué es?
Como lluvia o sol, brillo de
okay,
sol.
Ok. Chai or chai. Becky is a professional dog walker. She walk.
Jairo.
Sí.
Ah, pensé que me había desconectado.
No.
Vaya, entonces, vaya, ahora hay que ir viendo si las podemos ir contestando.
Ok.
Dice, after I win, I take a break.
I take a break.
¿Quién de los cuatro? Ajá. Toma
uh-huh. Video game tester. Lots of teenagers, grand job, blues job. He plays video games for 8 hours a day. And he
Did you finish?
No, finished.
Not yet.
Según la actividad es ver en qué párrafo está esa pequeña frase que está ahí. Si está en el párrafo de Lisa o de John.
Hoy sí.
Vale. Ya en la primera he puesto John Blue. Alter it with Altar K Bray. John Blue.
Ok.
En la dosis, I do usually work in the summer. Carlos Ruiz. Hola.
Hola, a mí ya no me aparece la página.
Did you get all the answers? All right, let's check the answers all together. Okay. All right, number one, after I win, I take a break. Who says that?
John Blue.
John Blue.
Okay, I don't usually work in the summer. Who says that?
Carlos
Ruiz.
Perfect pronunciation. Number three. Yeah. The restaurant closes late, around 2 a.m.
Lisa Parker.
Very good. And number four. After work, my feet and my arms are tired.
Tired.
Okay, perfect.
Yes, repeat, tired.
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 Perfect.
Tired.
So,
tired. Yeah.
Becky Peck. This one? I don't know. All right, I will submit it. Very good. We did great. All right. Excellent. Do you have any questions?
No.
No.
Nope. Okay. Empiecen con el midterm, por si hay preguntas antes del fin de semana. Alguien me escribió anoche preguntándome un tema. ¿Fue alguno de ustedes?
Yo, pero ya lo resolví.
¿Quién fue?
Yo, Jairo.
Jairo, ni lo veo, déjeme ver a dónde está. Ah, ya resolvió. Perdón.
Sí, ya lo resolví.
No, es que aquí es la 1 a.m. ya, entonces yo me fui a dormir.
No, sí. Pregunta. Pero sí, me quedé hasta anoche, pero...
Ah, pobre, no le
pero lo resolví.
No, yo me fui a dormir porque tenía que trabajar a las 8. Así que dije yo, bueno, en el día, pero no pude. Entonces estaba con eso, que me sentía mal que no le había contestado.
No, pero no, lo que pasa es que ese día yo me conecté tarde y quizás por eso no.
Se perdió un poco. Jorge, dígame. Ajá.
A mí me cuesta bastante entender cuando están escuchando. ¿Alguna sugerencia para comenzar a practicar e ir mejorando eso?
Ah, cuando hay un listening le cuesta entender.
Sí.
Fíjense que a veces el problema, uno es que hay que hacer tantos listenings como se pueda. Pero a veces el problema es que uno no tiene el vocabulario.
Ah, ok.
Entonces, por ejemplo, este que acabamos de hacer, esta lectura, tiene listening. y les puede servir para todo. Pongan el video y les sirve para vocabulario, para pronunciación, para listening. Todo está incluido. Entonces, ese, si lo repiten, les sirve para pronunciación. Si le ponen atención para listening. Y vocabulario, okay. Si hay palabras que no saben, tienen que buscarlas para ir expandiendo también el vocabulario. Y entonces, cuando usted lo vuelve a escuchar, ya son palabras familiares que usted conoce, okay. Es más fácil. Pero gracias. también hay un website que puede hacer ejercicios de listening todos los días. Aunque, okay. Ajá, se lo voy a escribir aquí al chat.
Ah, vaya,
igual, o se los muestro. Es muy fácil porque solo es ESL Lab. ESL.lab.com.
Lab.com.
Sí, okay. Muy bonito. Acá abajo se van a los listenings de fácil acá, a los de easy. Y lo pueden hacer desde su teléfono también. Entonces, escogen uno de esos, pero están un poco difíciles. Ok, entonces seleccionan uno de este, por ejemplo. Y tiene multiple choice, o sea, tiene opciones múltiples según lo que va escuchando usted y así practica. Eso lo puede hacer a diario.
Excelente. Muchas gracias.
Bueno, sí, ese es uno. Aunque están un poco complejos, están difíciles. Yo le recomendaría quizá primero ir con los diálogos y las lecturas del programa para empezar.
Ok.
Pero sí, si no, igual puede probar. A ver si le cuesta. Okay.
Ok.
Thank you, guys. See you bye. Tomorrow. Okay. Bye. Have a good night.
I see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.